Cybersecurity is a complex subject. Millions of moving parts, expanding attack surfaces, tons of technologies to learn, and creative attackers constantly changing their tactics and targets. In this video, I'm going to try to simplify the story and strip it all down to the fundamentals. Along the way, we're going to discuss what needs to be done, how we're going to do it, who needs to do it, and when. So, settle in, class. This is Cybersecurity 101, and we're going to learn about the three acronyms to rule them all. The first of the three acronyms I'm going to introduce you to is going to answer the what. What do we do in cybersecurity? And I'm going to suggest to you everything we do in cybersecurity is about this. It's about CIA. No, not the spy guys. It's something we call the CIA triad, where we've got confidentiality. That's basically keeping secrets secret, making information that's sensitive only available to the people that are authorized to see it. That's our first goal with CIA. The second is integrity. And in this case, we want to make sure that the data hasn't been tampered with, that it's still reliable. And then the last part of the CIA triad is availability. Availability is trying to guard against denial of service attacks, where an attacker is trying to take the system down, make it unavailable for everyone else. So the first thing to remember, what we're doing in cybersecurity is all about CIA, confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So now we know what we need to do. How are we going to go about doing it? Well, the acronym in this case to remember is PDR. It's prevention, detection, and response. And in everything that we're doing in cybersecurity in order to achieve the CIA, we're doing it through these kinds of methods. So for instance, there are technologies that will help us with prevention. For instance, cryptography will help us to make something so that not everyone can see it, as an example. Multi-factor authentication is another example, so that I can verify it's really you before I give you access to the information and decrypt it and let you read it. Roles-based access control is another way of doing more fine-grained control to say what kinds of things you're allowed to do and not. So these are a lot of prevention technologies. What kind of things can we do in the detection? Well, we can do logging, so that way we keep a list of all the activities that someone has done. We can monitor what's happening on the system so that we can tell if they do something that's incorrect. One of the technologies that we use here is a security information and event management system, SIM. And then lastly, there's response. So we've done the prevention, we've done the detection. That's if all the prevention didn't work, then we need to detect and find out what didn't work. Now we have to respond. And in this case, the traditional term was incident response. Now a more common term these days is SOAR, which is security, orchestration, automation, and response. So think about these two aspects, orchestration and automation. I want to automate as much of this as I possibly can, but I can't automate everything because in some cases, this is the first time we've ever seen it. So in those cases, I'm going to orchestrate a response. But I do some sort of technological advance that's going to make it easier for us to do this response. All right, the third acronym that we have to keep in mind in Cybersecurity 101 is PPT. And what I mean by this is people, process, and technology. Now, in this case, I'm a technologist, so I tend to think in terms of the tech, and I feel like that can solve most of the problems. And it can solve a lot of problems. I just gave you an example of how technology is used in the prevention, detection, and response. But that's not nearly enough, because tools alone will not solve the problems. We still have to have people involved in all of this, and they need to be trained. They need to know how to operate. They need to know how to guide the system and guide the steps through all of this process. They need to decide, after all, what prevention technologies we're going to use, what kind of detection schemes we'll do, and then ultimately make the decisions when we do responses. So those people will also interface with process. So we've got to have some sort of process, technology, these kinds of things that will guide the actions of those people. And then those processes and policies and procedures will ultimately be the things that we implement in the technology. So people, process, and technology. Okay, so there you go. Three acronyms to rule them all, just as I promised. CIA, confidentiality, integrity, and availability is the what. PDR, prevention, detection, and response is the how. And PPT, people, process, and technology is the who. Now, how about the when? When do you have to be able to do all of this? Well, the answer is pretty simple. It's 24/7. Because you have to be right all the time. The bad guys only have to be right once. They don't sleep, therefore you can't be caught napping.